Hey, what's up guys? I'm Daniel and I have received quite a few messages about filming and about how to get started. And so I wanted to take the opportunity to share with you the knowledge that I've learned from some of the professionals you see on TV and from me just trial and error and, you know, doing lots of reading and YouTube videos. Just wanted to share with you the knowledge that we have. And again, just want to make the disclaimer, we're not professionals. We don't have our content on TV, maybe one day, but we are here at Blood Trail TV serious about filming and putting our hunts out there on YouTube for you to enjoy, but it's not our day job. It is a hobby. It's probably more than a hobby if you ask our wives, but it is something we love to do. And so I wanted to take the opportunity and share with you guys the video knowledge that we have and want to make that available to you. So if you're interested in starting to do your own filming, you have somewhere to turn to, some free advice. And again, feel free to message myself or any of the other guys on the Blood Trail and ask us questions. We love sharing our knowledge. And so the first, I want to do a video series, a three-part series, and the first part of the series that I want to cover today is bow-mounted cameras. I get a lot of questions about this, about how do I mount it, where should I mount it, and a lot of that is done by trial and error. But before you can mount a camera to your bow, you've got to make the decision, number one, am I going to film the game that I'm hunting? Or number two, am I going to film myself shooting my bow as a secondary or third POV option? POV stands for point of view. And so what you'll see on TV and what you see in our episodes, we will typically run two or three additional point of view cameras to obtain what they call B-roll footage or extra footage or POV footage. It's additional extra footage other than the main camera that's always concentrated on trying to film the animals and then get the kill shot on film. So for me personally, what I'm going to show you on my bow, this particular camera right here, is this is the camera that I run on my bow. And it is used as a secondary point of view camera on myself to try and add to the footage when I'm self-filming, because majority of the time most of our footage you see is all self-filmed. So make that decision, figure out that you are going to aim it at the game or aim it at yourself, and then from there you can mount the camera to your bow and figure out what works best for you. So in this instance, this is a Vivitar HD camera. It's a GoPro knockoff. I purchased this camera at Walmart. It was about 60, 70 bucks, I think. It shoots in full 1080p high definition, runs on a micro SD card, and it has done a phenomenal job. I've captured some really good footage with it. It came with a waterproof housing. It comes with a couple different mounts. You know, all in all, for the money, it's a really good camera to get started. So I want to show you, I have this mounted up top here on my riser of my bow. So I've mounted mine here and I'm able to position this camera to capture myself when I'm self-filming. And then if you have a cameraman back behind you over your shoulder, you'll be able to pick up that additional footage of you trying to shoot the animal and the cameraman operating the regular camera. Makes for some really good footage. The next mount I want to talk about is a stabilizer mounted camera. This particular mount that I put on here just to make this video is a handlebar mount that attaches to a bicycle or a motorcycle or the frame of a go-kart, off-road buggy, four-wheeler, whatever. And it works great on these round stabilizers. This is a Shrewd hunting stabilizer that's 12 inches. This is the stabilizer that I hunt with on a regular basis. And it works perfect with it being just under an inch in diameter. I can mount this handlebar mount to it, mount this camera, this camera that I have mounted on here, just to show you, is the Excel HD from SpyPoint. It's a really great camera. Again, it films in full 1080p high definition. You can buy this camera as a package with the housing and a whole list of other accessories. They run anywhere from 200 to 300 bucks depending on what model you get. And this allows you to, how I've got this set up here, allows you to film your hunt out in front of you, the game that you'll be shooting at. There's tons of other action cameras out there that you can get a hold of. So do your research, check into them. Tacticam is extremely popular. They actually have a housing unit that screws into your stabilizer port on the front of your bow, and you stick the camera in there, and then the camera and the mount serves as a stabilizer, and you're able to hunt and record your footage. It makes for some really good footage. Of course, the most popular GoPro. GoPro's been in the works, in the scenes for a while now. They have a gun and bow mount that you can purchase as an accessory to their cameras that works very well. So lots of options. So do your research. Excuse me. Do your research. Figure out what camera is going to work best for you. And then experiment. If you're in a position where you can buy a couple different cameras, do that and experiment with those. If you're in a position to buy one, figure out which one is going to work best for you, and go from there. What I will tell you will be extremely beneficial to you is having a bow mounted camera requires practice. You will want to get it mounted and play several different times with how you want it mounted and practice like that. Adding a camera to a gun or a bow will add weight to that particular weapon, and it will change the way that it feels and it shoots in your hand. And I say that to say this: you don't want to mount your camera the day of season and head straight to the woods and go. Because there's a really good chance, if you're not careful, you'll get the camera mounted thinking that it's not in the way, and then when it comes time to take the shot or pull the trigger, it's right in your way, whether it's in your sight, your line of sight with your sight picture, trying to shoot your bow or your gun with a scope or a bow sight, mounting them on your stabilizer. Depending on where you put it, you can get it too close to your grip. If you're not careful and the height here that you see here, this sets up pretty tall. This camera mount would actually, on my particular bow, would interfere with my arrow if my arrow were right here. And then as you shoot longer distances, this is a movable sight housing that I shoot on my bow, and moving that sight for further distances, it would create some problems. So I, number one, choose not to, but number two, for technical reasons, could not run a stabilizer mounted camera up top unless I ran it out further up here and off to the side to where it wouldn't affect my arrow in the line of flight. So do your research, experiment with them, get them mounted to several different positions on your bow and find what works best for you, and then practice with it in the yard when you're target shooting and gearing up for deer season. Practice with the added weight. Go ahead and turn the camera on and get an idea of the footage that you're gonna be getting, and then go back and watch that footage and adjust accordingly. So, I hope this helps. Again, if you have any questions whatsoever about this, please feel free to message me on our Facebook page, facebook.com/thebloodtrail. If you're a friend of mine or know my personal Facebook page, get a hold of me through there as well. I'm happy to help anybody and everybody that I can about filming. And coming up on the next episode of the film series, part number two, we are going to look at how to self-film out of different tree stands. So whether you're hunting in a hang-on, a ladder stand, or a climber, or even a ground blind, we're going to run through those scenarios and how to properly set up your camera and your camera arm, and how to position your tree stand to, number one, get you a shot, and number two, hopefully capture that shot on video. So hunt hard, be safe, and God bless, and thanks for watching.